It is the printer paper. And this is test tube holder. And this is test tube stand. This is wire gauge. This is tripod stand. And this is Bunsen burner. This is filter stand. Phonics stand. Then comes to the chemicals required for this experiment. The chemicals which is required for this experiment are 1 is copper carbonate solid. This is copper carbonate solid. Look at the color of the solid. It is green color. Then another chemicals required for this experiment is dilute sulfuric acid. Look at this. Then come to the chemical equation. Here we have copper carbonate solid. When copper carbonate solid mixed with dilute sulfuric acid, upon heating or evaporate the solution, then we get the copper sulfate crystals. We get the copper sulfate crystals and hydrogen gas is coming out and water molecules are removed here. Then comes to the diagram. Here there are so five diagrams are there. We have to follow five steps for the process of crystallization. Before going to the process of crystallization, we have to know that what is a salt, how the salt is formed. A salt is formed by the combination of an acid with a base, and this process is also called neutralization process. Salt may acquire crystalline state and amorphous state. Here our copper sulfate crystal form in crystalline state. Then how will you detect whether the salt is crystalline or amorphous? Then we have to rub the salt in our finger like that. If it smoothens, then we indicate that or concluded that the salt is in powder form. So it is amorphous salt. But when we rub the salt and get a regular shape or geometry, then it is called crystalline shape. So our copper sulfate crystal that we collected from this experiment, that is crystalline shape. Then comes to the process of crystallization. The process of crystallization takes place in five steps. Here the first step is preparation of solution. For the preparation of solution, we have to take the two chemicals, that is dilute sulfuric acid and copper carbonate solid. We have to add the copper carbonate solid and dilute sulfuric acid and mix it by the help of this glass rod. And upon stirring, we get a clear solution. And after some time, we get the solid, that is copper carbonate, is sometimes some amount left at the bottom of the beaker. Then we have to stop adding the copper carbonate solid, because here we have received or indicate that the solution is saturated. We indicate the saturation point here. So we don't have to add any other or any amount of solid. Then comes to the filtration process. Before going to the filtration process, we have to heat the solution. Because why we heat the solution? Because the carbon dioxide that are present in the solution have to remove. So we have to heat the solution first. Then cool down the solution. After that we have to filter the solution. For the filtration process, we have to take a funnel. Take a funnel and to place the funnel, we have to take a funnel stand. This is funnel stand. We have to put the funnel and a filter paper is taken. Filter paper, a circular filter paper is taken. Here we have to fold the circular filter paper into semi-circular halves like that. Look at like that. Then refold it like that. Then open the filter paper in such a way that the three layers of the filter paper in one side and the other layer in the other side. We have to fix the filter paper into the funnel or insert the filter paper into the funnel. How the filter paper and the funnel is sticking? By the help of some water, we have to moisturize the wall of the funnel with water, then have to insert the filter paper. Then this is called China dish. A China dish is placed at the stem of the funnel. Then have to filter the solution like a position with the glass rod. A glass rod is connected with the wall of the filter paper. Then have to pour the solution in the beaker. In the demonstration part, I will showing you this part. Then comes to the concentration and evaporation of the solution. First step, the concentration of or evaporation of solution is required to get the pure crystals form copper carbonate solution. So we have to concentrate or heating the solution after some time and have to reach the crystallization point. How will you detect the crystallization point? We have to blow air from our mouth to the glass rod that is contain the solution in one mouth of the glass rod. Then we have to blow the air. Then the solid particles are formed outside the rod. Then we have to stop heating. This is the crystallization point. So it is the crystallization point. We don't have to evaporate the solution beyond the crystallization point. If we heat more times or beyond the crystallization point, then the crystals are not formed. If formed, it is thinning quantity and have different structure. So we have to stop heating when the crystallization point is reached. Then comes to the fifth point, that is separation of crystals from the water liquid. This is the last point, and drying the crystals. For in after half an hour of cooling the solution, then we get some pure crystals with some impurities present, liquid impurities present upper the China dish. Upper the China dish, we get some liquid impurities. These liquid impurities are removed by pouring the solution or decanting of the solution. These upper layer impurities are called mother liquor. Then the crystal containing some water. How the crystals are drying? We have to take some filter paper, holding two folds of filter paper, we have to collect the wetted crystal, that is it contains some hydrated molecule. Water particles are there. So we have to, with the help of this filter paper, we can dry the crystals. So then comes to the demonstration part. Abhilash sir will show you the demonstration part.
Dear students, Sri Abhilash Dhar will demonstrate the crystallization experiment.
Then comes to the demonstration part. Abhilash sir will show you. Then come to the process of crystallization. The first step of process of crystallization is preparation of solution. For preparing the solution, we have to take a clean and dry beaker first. Then we have to pour a test tube full of dilute sulfuric acid, that is contains 20 milliliter of dilute sulfuric acid. 20 milliliter of dilute sulfuric acid was poured to the beaker. Then copper carbonate solid was added gradually pinch by pinch. With the help of a glass rod, we have to stir the solution. The solution was continuously stirred till some solids of copper addition. So upon addition of copper carbonate is not required. Then the solution was heated 2 to 3 minutes for removing carbon dioxide gas.
Now
concentrate is hitting. We have to stir with the help of this glass rod. Constant stirring is required in this process. At regular intervals, we have to check the crystallization point by blowing the air from your mouth to the one point of the glass rod. If any solid particles are formed at the glass rod, then we have to remove the burner because the solution reaches the crystallization point. Regular stirring is required. To check the crystallization point, we have to blow the air from your mouth and the rod dipped with the solution was checked whether the glass rod mouth contain any solid substance or not. If any solid substance found, then stop hitting. Our solution is reached the crystallization point. Look at the rod, mouth of the rod, now it is clear, no solid particles are formed. So wait for some time. Vigorous stirring is required. Then remove the burner. And with the help of this tong, we have to put the filtrate upon a beaker which is containing cold water. Then we have to place the filtrate in undisturbed position for half an hour for slowly cool down. Because the crystals have take some time to form, we have to cool down the reaction mixture slowly. If we cool down the mixture faster, then the crystals are not formed or form it may have structures different from crystalline structure. That is removal of mother liquor from the crystal and drying of crystal. After half an hour, our filtrate is cooled down. Now half an hour is over. Our crystal are formed at the bottom of the porcelain basin and a liquid impurity is present on the top layer of the porcelain basin. This is mother liquor. We have to pour the mother liquor by the decantation process like this. This is mother liquor. That are the impurities. Then The crystals are present at the bottom of the porcelain basin. Now the last part we have to follow. We have to dry the crystals that are contain the water molecules. We have to dry the crystals in two folds of the filter paper. The filter paper soaks the waters, then we get the dried form of crystals. Press gently the crystals. Now we get the dry crystals. It is dry cleaning step. Look at the crystal and look at the blackboard. Here the crystal is dry cleaning step. This step is called dry cleaning step. And we get the dry cleaning step crystals. The color of the crystal is blue. Structure is dry cleaning, crystalline structure, and the yield of the substance is approximately 7 grams. Now we concluded that copper sulfate crystals we are preparing from copper carbonate and dilute sulfuric acid solution. Now, some precautions that we have taken at the time of crystallization. First precaution is, don't evaporate the solution beyond the crystallization point. If we heat the solution beyond the crystallization point, then the crystals are may not be formed. If formed, have stringy structures. So we don't have to heat the crystallization solution beyond the crystallization point. Then don't press the crystals strongly. Have to press the crystals gently, because if we pressurize the crystal, then the structure of the crystal is broken. We don't get the triclinic shape of the crystal. And we have to remove the carbon dioxide upon when we add the copper carbonate solution preparation.
Demonstration is now over. So thank you to all.